Lancashire were crowned this year's LV County Champions after they beat Somerset and Taunton to take the title with just 29 balls of the season to spare. It was that kind of year. A very warm welcome to our final monthly review of what has been another thrilling LV County Championship season in both divisions, with the title, promotion and relegation issues all going down to the wire. We'll be catching up with the champions shortly, but before we do, let's take a look at a special six of the best. We start with our top three players of the season. At six, we put our batsman of the year, Marcus Truscothick of Somerset. You only have to see how Somerset's LV County Championship campaign folded once he injured his ankle to see just how important he is to his county. Had he not hurt himself and missed the last three games of the summer, he may well have gone on to amass 2,000 runs for the season. The 35-year-old would have surely have passed his previous best for a year of 1,817 runs made 2 years ago. With 600s, including two doubles, he ended the summer with a batting average of 80, having smashed 1,673 runs, 1,076 of them coming in boundaries alone. He is a batsman still very much at the peak of his game, and he'll be the one to beat again in 2012. At five, we have a championship debutant in Gloucestershire's Will Gidman, whose stats this year may come as a surprise to many. Having sat on the sidelines at Durham for four seasons without ever getting a game in the LV County Championship, Gidman moved south to join his older brother in Bristol, and there was not too much of a fanfare about that. Yet he ended the season as the country's premier all-rounder, with 3 5-wicket hauls in his 51 wickets, while he also scored 1,006 runs. Few players managed the double of 50 wickets and 1,000 runs in a season, but Gidman is now up amongst the best. He reached a target of both in his final game at Northamptonshire, where he wasn't quite able to see Gloucestershire earn what many would have seen as a very unlikely promotion. His sophomore season will be one to watch with interest. At three, we give our award to our player of the season, and that goes to Essex's David Masters, who had a summer he will never forget. Not since the introduction of the divisions, and therefore the cut in the number of matches, has anyone taken so many wickets in a championship campaign. Hardly a week went by when he was not taking a fifer. He did it an amazing 8 times in the season, as he took his toll of wickets to an incredible 93, the best tally by any bowler since Franklin Stevenson in 1988. Masters' previous best summer came last year, when he claimed 53 victims, but he knocked that into a cocked hat this time around. His best effort came in the height of the summer when he took 8 Leicestershire wickets for only 10 runs, as they were bowled out for just 34. It turned out to be a good year for the 30-somethings, with the 36-year-old Alan Richardson leading the bowling charts in the first division as well. Masters, at 33 years of age, bowled 637 overs, more than anyone except Monty Panesar and Richardson. He secured 169 maidens, second to Panesar again, and took 93 for 1,687 runs, giving him an extraordinary average of just 18. Now to the run-in for the title, and at number three on our charts we have Warwickshire's Shivnarine Chanderpaul. What an impact he made since arriving late to replace Jeetan Patel in their side. He hit 200s in 2 games against Yorkshire, including one in the final month in Birmingham. He'd already taken the same opposition for 193 in Leeds, before adding 110 runs at home and another undefeated 56 in a weather-ruined run chase in the second innings. The 37-year-old, in his 21st year as a professional, then produced another mammoth innings at the Rose Bowl to put his side ahead in the title race. A race they lost, of course, right at the death. In spite of a couple of low scores when he first arrived, the West Indian scored 539 runs in 7 innings at an average of 90. You can hardly ask for any more from an overseas player. Warwickshire would have had one hand on the trophy with a week of the season remaining, had it not been for Simon Kerrigan, who comes in at number 2 with the best bowling analysis of the season, an incredible 9 for 51, as he bowled Lancashire to a 222-run win over Hampshire to keep his side right on the coattails of Warwickshire. Kerrigan, an England Lion, was playing in only his 3rd LV County Championship match of the summer, but he showed that he has a very big future by bowling his side to a famous victory, with just 3 minutes to spare in Liverpool. The game was heading towards a draw until Carrigan switched to the river end and took 3 wickets for no runs in 8 balls. Some of his vicious spinning and spitting deliveries were just about unplayable, and although the last Hampshire pair survived for 21 overs, Carrigan produced a peach to remove Neil McKenzie in the final over to keep Lancashire in the thick of the title race and just about condemn Hampshire to relegation. So to number one, and we have the moment that Lancashire won the LV County Championship title for the first time outright since 1934. This was it, as Steven Croft struck the winning runs in Taunton just 10 minutes after Warwickshire had drawn their final match at the Rose Bowl. The celebration started immediately, and none more so for the man who struck the final runs.
Unbelievable. Words can't describe it, to be honest. I've since I joined staff 7 years ago, it was 70 years since we won the championship, and I thought we might have won it by then. But yeah, it's something you dream of, to hit the winning runs for your county, who I've been involved in since I was 12, 13 years old. And yeah, it's a very special moment for me.
Special moment for you. You've done it before, of course, with Sussex. What's the secret? Have you got the Midas touch?
I don't know. Maybe just a bit of luck. I mean, at the moment, all I can say about this group of players is they're committed. We've got great senior players, Mark Chilton, Glen Chapple, Gary Keane, who set a fantastic example. And the young players, they want to work. They want to work and get stuck in. The message is the same for all of us. Do your basics, keep it simple, and then, you know, the game hopefully will look after you. And that's what they've done.
We've talked before about this 77-year thing that's been hanging around you for this year, but it's 70 on, 71, it goes on and on and on. Thankfully, we can all shut up about it.
You can shut up about it, yeah, and we can enjoy playing. I mean, the nice thing is the side's young. The side's young and fresh, so they're going to, you know, enjoy tonight, they'll reflect on it, and they'll know, I think, that they've got great potential for the future, which is going to be exciting, hopefully, for people to watch.
Trophy in the hand, can you believe it?
Not yet, no. Just delighted for the players. They've been absolutely brilliant all year. This is a difficult trophy to win, as Lancashire have proved over the years. But, you know, we've finally done it, and obviously all the lads are ecstatic, and I'm really proud of every one of them.
It means a huge amount, obviously, to the county. What about you personally?
I've had 20 years, and it seems to get harder every year, but the cricket that we've played this year, and to only just win it, shows how hard it is, but we've had many tight games, which makes it all the better, really, to be honest. Our fans have been great all the way through. I think there's been a lot of belief from about halfway through the season within the county that we had a chance. But, you know, it went right to the wire, and it's very difficult to bear at times, but we've stuck with it, and we've come out on top. It's great.
War of the Roses, Lancashire win the title, Yorkshire get relegated. Who would believe that?
Yeah, I mean, and you always feel for fights. You know, every side will work really hard. Yorkshire will have worked hard like everybody else. It hasn't worked for them or whatever, but that's the way the game goes. You know, we'll enjoy it while we can, but, you know, credit to the county championship, that how hard Somerset fought and how hard Hampshire fought to make sure the integrity of the competition was kept.
The North West, of course, famous for its great football teams, its rugby league teams. Now you put cricket right on the map.
Yeah, it's been brilliant. I've a big sports fan myself, and yeah, we've always been close. I think the last few years we've come second. I was involved in the 0-7 defeat at Surrey, which hurt a lot, where we were 20-odd runs short. But yeah, it's been amazing to be a part of this team. It's a brilliant team spirit, and hopefully more trophies to come.
So this is how it all finished. Lancashire supporters can now press pause and stare. They won more matches, 10, than anyone else, and they lost fewer than all others with just 2 defeats. Their margin of success was 11 points. Yorkshire and Hampshire were the sides relegated to the second division with only 3 wins each all year. They will be replaced by Middlesex and Surrey, the 2 big London rivals. Surrey's race to the top flight was remarkable as they won their last 4 games, taking 89 points in the process, to nick the second promotion place from Northamptonshire by a single point. Middlesex were amongst the leaders all summer and took the second division title by 13 points. They nearly missed out during their last match at Grace Road, where they collapsed, as did Jamie Dalrymple. This incident being the first of our best and worst moments of the summer. That kind of thing can happen to the very best of players, though. Even someone with the talents of Ian Bell can't always keep his feet firmly on the ground. If you think that he had little chance of playing that grubber, then spare a thought for Glamorgan's Graham Wagg at Leicester. A shovel or a digger might have been more useful than a bat. There has been some indifferent running between the wickets at times this year, this being amongst the worst, as Durham's Ben Stokes and Gordon Muttall almost went choosing curtains together. From the ridiculous to the sublime, and we've had some brilliant wicket-keeping this year as well. These are some of the finest moments behind the stumps. In the last month, Somerset's Joss Butler produced something outstanding to remove Neil McKenzie in Taunton. Two former England keepers also proved that they still have what it takes. Chris Reid claimed this blinder down the leg side, while Kent's Geraint Jones produced some real magic to get rid of Surrey's Stuart Meeker. And Worcestershire's Ben Scott showed that it's not only the big names who can reach for the remarkable from time to time. Dominic Cork, the unlucky batsman, on that occasion. His wicket was obviously a very valuable one during the summer. When Yorkshire's Adil Rashid had him leg before, back in the height of it, his teammates jumped for joy, quite literally. But if you want to see pictures of unconfined happiness, then look no further than Lancashire, who will remember the 2011 season for a very long time to come. Many congratulations to them. It's been another wonderful season of LV County Championship cricket. After the final day drama of last year in Manchester, you would have expected to go through such a nail-biting final week again. As the sun sets on this season, let's hope that 2012 brings us all the drama, skills, brilliance and entertainment yet again. Thankfully, there's only 6 months or so to go.